Welcome to Life Speakers Radio Show, a show that will encourage, give hope, and speak life to inspire and motivate those who want to refresh their passion for life and live it to the fullest. Feel free to tune in and listen to the inspired words from Life Speakers Sharon Dotson and Wayne I. Dotson, who speaks life the way God gives to them, and the guests that will assist and help bringing hope, motivation, and encouragement to you along life's journey to understand that everything will work out for your good to help you survive and thrive the tests of life that may come your way to walk in destiny and purpose. Hey, what's going on, radio world? Welcome to Life Speakers Radio Show right here on WIGO 1570. This is Wayne ID holding down for my mom, Sharon Dotson. And hey, we doing it all good and big. So love you, mom. Thank you so much. Hope you hold it down where you at. So hey, I want to say, hey, everybody, I hope y'all had a good week. Hopefully y'all are good and having a good rise and had a good ease. Because we doing right here, Life Speakers, speaking life the way God gives to us. So hey, right now, you're going to hear God through me, and any positivity that comes out of me is for the worth and for the good, okay? Because we're doing it big right here, and I want to let you know that, hey, if nobody ever told you, you are enough. You can do whatever that God, anything through Christ that God strengthens you, and your world will turn out well. Any problems you got, you can give it all to Him and trust Him with every word and every knowledge and every worth, that you are worth something better and greater. You can do it all. You can have it all. So, hey, this is me, Wayne ID, telling you, you are enough. So, hey, let's get on and do it big right now. And even though, hey, it's just me, but hey, I got a guest with me, and she is doing it all, and she got some life to speak from her perspective. So, right now, I want to introduce to Miss Lady. Introduce yourself, special guest.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Apostle Alicia Cardwell Alston with Revolutionary Grace Church, where the gospel is changing lives, where my husband and I, Pastor Jerry Alston, are located in College Park on Godby Road. And I am so excited to be here this afternoon to give to you what God has given me. And I pray that they will be eye-openers. Praise God. Hallelujah. Eye-openers. And I just pray right now that the Holy Spirit will fall fresh in this place. Hallelujah. Have your way, Lord. Have your way in me. Touch the hearts and minds of every single person under the sound of my voice. Hallelujah. May their lives be changed by the living word of God. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Yeah, amen. That's amazing. That's great. Shouts out to everybody in College Park Town.
Yes.
Hey, a lot of people. I lot of people who come from that town, even a friend who has a church, and he be working behind the scenes and building the church up in the best way possible.
Yes.
So, hey, y'all doing it big right there, ma'am. Miss Alicia, Miss Apostle. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. It's okay. Praise God. Hallelujah. So listen, today I am so excited. I am so excited because I have a message for you today. A message from God. Hallelujah.
Yes, ma'am. Let's do it.
Yes, and the message today is see it before you see it.
Yeah, that's right.
Y'all, listen to that for a moment. See it before you see it. Hallelujah.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, prepare to see. Prepare to see what God is going to take you from. What is God? Well, what the path that when you keep yourself on his path and see what's to come and what's to expect, expect the greatest, expect the wealth, the knowledge, the wealth, the strongness of him and his son, Jesus Christ. Let's not forget what his son, Jesus Christ, did to save our sins so we won't have to pay for it.
Come on. It's already been atoned for.
Yes, ma'am.
It's already been taken care of. Jesus said, it is finished. Hallelujah. It is finished.
Yeah, yeah.
And we know that in Hebrews 11 and 1, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Hallelujah. So those things that are not seen are not seen by physical eyes. They're not seen by your five senses, by your feeling and touching. Hallelujah. By all the physical things that we're used to relying on. We're talking about things unseen. So let's let you know that you got to see them in the spirit realm. Hallelujah. You got to see it with a spiritual eye. And so as I share some eye openers today, hallelujah, I pray that there be some things that are revealed today, some things that are unfolded, unpacked for you. Hallelujah. And that after this message that you won't be the same. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So listen, I want to come from Ephesians 1 and 3.
Oh, yes, ma'am. What's
Ephesians
up with
1
that?
And 3. Praise God. And it says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every, I said every, I didn't say some, I didn't say, you know, a lot. I said every spiritual blessing
every.
In the heavenly realms. Every, come on.
All,
right?
Yes,
all,
ma'am.
We know what all means. All, every, in the heavenly realms, in Christ. Hallelujah. What a rich text right here. What a rich text in Ephesians 1 and 3, as we're talking about seeing it. See it before you see it. And so I want to just start with the beginning of that, because it says, blessed be the God. I'm going to break this down. Blessed be the God.
Oh,
in the
yes.
Amplified, it says, blessed and worthy of praise.
Oh, yes.
Blessed and worthy of praise. And we're talking
wow.
about God the Father, okay?
Oh, yes.
Blessed and worthy of praise. And so when we're talking about seeing it before you see it, how many know how important it is to be thankful?
Oh,
how
yes.
many know how important it is to give praise,
oh,
give
yes.
honor, give glory, hallelujah, so that your spiritual eyes can be open and you connect with the Father?
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Gotta acknowledge him. Gotta
acknowledge him. The Word of God says, acknowledge him in all your ways and he'll direct your path.
Yes, ma'am.
Hallelujah.
Apostle, that is great, because everything that's going on, like with the world and everything else, you got to give him praise. You got to give him credit. You got to
yes.
let him know that you know, you acknowledge him in your life, and
yes.
you keep him in your life, and you're on his path.
Absolutely.
And thank him for all the stuff. And you're alive. You're
yes.
breathing well.
Come on.
So
you got new life.
You got new life on you, and you got
yes.
more life ahead of you.
Come on.
So you got to thank him for that and give you breath to wake up every morning and give you
yes.
a perspective and give you the motivation to get up and do whatever it is on the assignment that he's assigned for you.
Praise God.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Ma'am.
That thanksgiving is so key.
Oh,
it's
yes.
so essential, because you're acknowledging that he's the giver of the gifts. He's the giver of the talent. He's the giver of life when you praise him and you thank him. So I love that first part of this scripture. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Listen, right there is relationship. Hallelujah.
Oh.
You're talking about your spiritual eyes being open. You got to know who you're in relationship with.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Who you're relating to. Who you're talking to,
it's
right?
Facts. Facts right there.
Right? Who you're talking to.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Who is the keeper of your soul? Who is the one? Hallelujah, who is Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Who's the author and finisher of your faith? Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah. Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Gotta keep that
I love that, because we have to look to the one and only true and living God. Many people look to other things. Many people got these, you know, self-empowerment programs and affirmations that they say, and all of it is outside of the Word of God, but you got to come to the source. And the source is Jesus. Hallelujah.
Of course, the source, that source is amazing. Jesus. Because,
yes.
yeah, you got, like, we even, one time we talked about, me and my mom, and then another friend of ours from church, we talked about different affirmations.
Yes.
We talk about affirmations and setting standards for ourselves.
Yes.
And to, you know, set goals and what we want to do to change ourselves, you know, spiritually, mentally, physically.
Yes.
And try to, you know, set those affirmations in sight and set them in motion and try to do whatever we can to live up to the high expectation.
Yes.
I mean, if not the high expectation, you do all you can. You do all the best you can for God and Jesus.
Absolutely.
Those guys, because those guys, you got to worship them through in sickness. Hey, just like in relationships, in sickness and health or in marriages and stuff like that. But also, you got to do it either way, through the good. And also through the bad.
Wow. Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Whether you're feeling good, whether you're feeling bad, you got to talk to God and know that Him and Jesus Christ, they got your back.
Yes. Hallelujah.
You can trust them. If you can't have a conversation, if you're going through a situation and you're too embarrassed to tell anybody, then you can tell God. Have that one-on-one session while you're in a quiet mode, while you to yourself, and let Him know that, you know, God, please help me with this and all that stuff. Please help me. I'm going through this situation and I'm stressing and I'm depressed over it. But at the end of the day, you got to give it to Him and let Him do the fight for you.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
Hallelujah.
Ma'am.
And you know, as you say that, have Him do the fight for you.
Yes, ma'am.
We got to know that when He went to the cross, He gave us the victory.
Oh, yes. Wow.
Hallelujah.
Yes, ma'am.
When He went to the cross, He gave us the victory. And so, you know, as we come into the battlefield, because I got to let you know, if you don't know, mm-hmm. when you accepted Jesus, hallelujah, you stepped into the battlefield. And even if you didn't, you stepped into the battlefield, except when you accepted Jesus, you stepped in on the winning side.
Oh,
hallelujah.
Yes, ma'am.
That's the difference. And so as we go into the battle every single day, all we have to do is stand in Him.
Yes,
the Word of God in Ephesians 6 and 10 said, be strong in the Lord.
Oh, yes.
And in the power of His might. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Our strength and our power and our might comes from God, and it's standing power, staying power. Hallelujah. That you can stand up against anything in Christ, which we're about to get to. Hallelujah.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Let's do
Hallelujah.
It.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the verse goes on to say, who has blessed us, who has, past tense, who has blessed us. The blessings are already here. The blessings are already available. Hallelujah. We just have to connect with them. We just have to pull them down. We just have to bring them manifest right here in the natural physical realm. Hallelujah. Y'all staying with me today.
Oh,
hallelujah.
Yes, ma'am.
Seeing it before you see it. It's already done. It's already established.
Yes.
I love the word in even Jeremiah 29:11. He said, for I know the plans that I have for you. In those plans, don't you think it's blessings? Don't you think it's success in Jesus, in the kingdom? Hallelujah.
Exactly, yes.
There are great things that God has already done for us in His plans for us. But
yes,
do
ma'am.
You believe it? So that's what I want to get to.
Oh, yes.
That's what we're talking about today, really. We're talking about belief.
Believing. Believing. And also trusting in God that know that He can fix all things, whatever problems, whatever situations, or when you're up nervous, like, hey, when you're nervous about a big day or something, a little task you got to come create or impress in front of people, just give it to God and just pray about it and don't worry. Don't stress. And also, like you said, it's already done. The blessings, miracles to come. Just claim it's going to be done and it's going to come to you.
Yes.
Everybody who deserves it, they will get it.
And
it will come to.
Everybody who deserves it is a believer.
Yes, believer. Yes, have to believe.
That's what gives you that deserve level.
You got to
believe.
You got to believe. You got to trust. Yes, accept Jesus. Accept God in your life. And know that He exists.
Yes.
And you're on His path. And you're going to do the quest for knowledge for Him. And do whatever assignments that He assigned to you.
Hallelujah.
And figure out your purpose. I know there are a lot of us that probably don't know what our purpose is on this earth. Mm-hmm. But you will figure it out. God will see you through that path.
As you spend time with Him, God reveals His purpose to you.
Most definitely.
That's the key. Spending time with the Father, spending time with the Son, being led by the Holy Spirit who lives and dwells in you. Hallelujah. Praise God. So the word says in Ephesians, I'm still in Ephesians 1 and 3, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing. Hallelujah. How many know that you are spiritual? How many know that you are a spirit being? You got a mind, you got a will, you got emotions. That's your soulish realm.
Oh, yes.
What you're looking at right now is an earth suit.
An earth suit. Oh, yes, ma'am. Wow.
Because the real you is on the inside. That's your spirit, man. Hallelujah. This is an earth suit to keep us here on earth to do the will and plan and purpose of God. Hallelujah. But this isn't who we are. Hallelujah. We operate through this earth suit. Praise God, being led by the Holy Spirit who lives and dwells on the inside of us. So when it talks about spiritual blessings, we got to, access them in the spirit realm. Amen. Hallelujah.
Oh,
the
Word
of God says, come to God in spirit and in truth.
Oh, wow. Wow. That's
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In spirit and in truth. And so when we look at things in the heavenly realms, we got to know, listen, the word of God tells us that, yes, we are here in the earth. We are in the earth, but not of the, we're in the world, not of the world. We walk down here, but we're also in heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Of course.
Yes.
That makes so perfect sense. Apostle Alicia, that's just amazing.
Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So lastly, I want to talk about being in Christ. Praise God, because that's where your identity is. Your identity is not what you have, not what you drive, not where you live, not your job.
Not all about, yeah, it's not all of that, what you drive, what you car, what you have, and all the money in the world. Can that really save you?
Absolutely not. It said, what good is it to gain the whole world but to lose your soul?
Yes, ma'am.
Hallelujah. You're right on it.
Yes,
absolutely.
Ma'am.
And so when it talks about being in Christ, that's our identity. That's who we are. That's how we do what we do in the earth. That's how, listen, when we see ourselves in Christ and we understand who we are in Christ, that's how we flow in the Holy Spirit. That's how we walk in the Spirit, as the Word of God says, and we don't fulfill the desires of the flesh. Praise God.
Yes, ma'am.
We
understand.
Amen. We're in Christ. Who is Christ? He is holy. He is righteous. He is omnipotent, which means he's all powerful. He's omniscient, means he's everywhere, all at the same time. Omnipresent.
Oh, yes.
Omniscient means that he's all knowing.
Oh, yes, ma'am. He everywhere, everywhere.
Yes.
Even when you think, even when you feel like you're alone.
Yes.
Certain situations, you may feel like, oh, I'm by myself, or if my friends or my family are not with me, then at least God is with me.
Yes.
I have him. He's behind me all the time. He's
yes.
standing right there with me, even though I feel alone, even though I feel powerless.
Yes.
But I got the power of God turning
on
me.
Come on. The power of God lives on the inside of you. And
exactly.
I love that you said that, because listen.
Yes, ma'am.
That same resurrection power. Come on now. The same resurrection power that raised Jesus from the dead.
Yes, ma'am.
Is in you.
Yes, ma'am. Wow.
It's in you. You got resurrection power. Hallelujah. When you feel powerless, you need to remind yourself that same power that raised Jesus from the dead is in me.
Yes, ma'am. Wow. That's amazing. Yeah, just like Mary said, it's the God in me.
It's the God in me.
Yes.
It is the God in me. And so, you know, listen, this is the importance of studying and meditating and reading the Word of God. When you get that Word inside of you, nobody can take it away.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes.
Nobody can take it away.
Nobody.
It affirms you. It strengthens you. It comforts you. It gives you peace. It gives you joy.
And God will always keep you.
Come on.
He got
you understand.
And he will keep you. So
yes.
Nobody can take the relationship away that he has with you away from you.
Come on. Hallelujah.
Yeah. So right now, before we continue on, I want to go to a little break. We're going to have a song from
yes.
Yolanda Adams.
Praise God.
Yes. It's called Never Give Up. So we're going to let that play on, and then we're going to come right back. And Miss Apostle Alicia, we're going to let you finish out and fill more words in with what, and speak more life into the listeners' worlds.
Praise
so you're listening to Life Speakers Radio Show. We'll be right back. And here is Yolanda Adams, Never Give Up.
Deep inside, victory comes in time. Work today to change tomorrow. It gets easier. Who's to say that you can't fly? Every step take you get closer to your destination. You can feel it now. Don't you know you're almost there?
Going on live speakers, ready live speakers listeners, this is Wayne ID coming right back to you, and we right here with Apostle Alicia. What's going on, ma'am?
Oh man, I'm just excited about God.
Hallelujah. Oh my God, yes, that's Hallelujah. Amazing and yes. Good, and this song was picked out by her.
Yes, don't ever give up.
Don't ever give up.
You
don't
have no
ever
reason to give up. Don't. Jesus is your hope.
Exactly. Do not give. Do not ever give the. If you giving up, you giving the devil power to control your life.
Come on.
So please don't ever give up. And all the naysayers, all the negative ones who didn't believe in you.
Yes.
You're going to give them power to tell you to quit and like not follow your dreams and follow your goals and beliefs and morals.
Yes.
Hey, you go. Don't ever go against your standards, because if you quit, you're going against your standards and your moral beliefs.
Jesus didn't quit.
Yes, most definitely.
Come on. Look, he
kept going. Yeah.
All the way to the cross.
Yes, even had people, even people that did him so wrong.
Yes.
And he still kept going and being the good person that he is.
Hallelujah. 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 The great I am. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes,
ma'am. Praise God. So we're talking about seeing it before you see it. Hallelujah.
Oh, yes, most
seeing
definitely.
Seeing it before you see it out of Ephesians 1 and 3. And so I just want to read this scripture one more time. It's so powerful. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us, hallelujah, that's you and me, every single believer, with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly realms in Christ, hallelujah. If you're in Christ, that you got, then you got every spiritual blessing in the heavenly realms. And so I want you to know today, hallelujah, if you're talking about sickness, if you're talking about deliverance, anything that you need from God, I want you to know that you already have it. Hallelujah. You already have it. All God wants you to do is to believe.
Believe and believe. Also acknowledge that you got what it takes.
Believe. Praise God.
You got this. Hey, yes. like I always say, you got this. Anybody Hallelujah. Out there who are unable to believe, who don't trust, just know that you got this. As long as you believe and trust in God that He'll make way for you, you got this. And most of all, He got you. He got the whole situation. So you got to trust Him to take care of it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He knows the beginning from the end. Hallelujah. And I want to encourage you, when we talk about seeing it before you see it, you got to envision it. You got to use your Holy Ghost imagination. God gave us imagination. We know the devil tries to use imagination for things that are evil and things that are dirty and things that are sinful. But God gave you a pure and holy imagination to be able to envision.
Yeah, that's right.
What he's already given you.
Never settle for what the devil imagined for you.
Yes,
you gotta imagine.
Yes.
You gotta imagine that life and fantasize that life for you and for what
yes.
God has planned for you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You got to envision it. You got to see it on the inside first. Praise God. You know, God is so amazing. You know, I know with me, He works so much in me in dreams and in visions. Praise God. And showing me things. And it's up to us as His sons, as His daughters, to believe what He is showing us, believe what He has set before us in order for us to grab hold of it. If somebody comes to you and gives you something of value and you don't understand the value of it, hallelujah, you're going to push it aside. You're going to brush it aside. You're not even going to value it.
No, you're not going to ask questions like what it can do for you.
Hallelujah.
You gotta
How
ask.
Valuable is this that I have in my hand? Praise
you got,
God.
You got to understand the value of things.
Yes.
If anybody gives you, or if it's coming from a place of love and positivity. So you got to know, you got to ask questions like, what does this mean for me in my life
yes.
and my lifetime and what I'm supposed to do? What's the purpose of this?
Come on.
But you got to ask questions. Don't
you
just take
questions.
It and be like, I don't want, like, you got to ask questions and know what the answer is.
And listen, the answer's on the inside of you through the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. He'll
exactly.
give you the answer. He's a God of all wisdom.
Exactly. Exactly. God
Hallelujah.
Is the answer.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. And
on the inside of us.
Yes, ma'am. Miss Apostle Alicia, I'm so sorry, but our time is about to come short.
All right. Well,
but if you want to give anybody information of where you are and where
yes.
your church is, or how they can follow you, are you on social media? Your number?
Absolutely. Well, we are on Facebook. Our church again is Revolutionary Grace Church.
Okay.
We are located at 2245 Godby Road in College Park. I want you all to come visit with us, fellowship with us. Hallelujah. God is really moving, hallelujah, in our ministry as we submit to Him and look to Him. And we have great expectation. Let me tell you that. Hallelujah. But reach out to us, 404-455-6678. You can call us. You can go on the web, revolutionarygracechurch.com. We'd love to see you, fellowship with you, love on you. Hallelujah. And just celebrate who we are in Christ.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, ma'am. I can imagine y'all got good vibes around there. So,
hey,
y'all doing it big, and we got to have you back. Hopefully my mom can definitely catch you, and she probably had a lot to say if she was here. But,
yes.
Hey, so I just want to thank you so much, radio listeners.
Yes,
radio listeners, thank you so much for tuning in to Life Speakers Radio Show, and you will catch us next Saturday. And until then, y'all have a good day. Y'all take care and hold it down and wherever you at. And remember to trust and believe God and also see what He sees.
Praise God.
So y'all peace out. Much love. Y'all take it easy. All right. Bye bye.
My brothers and sisters all around the world, especially those in South Africa, struggling with AIDS. Brazil, the States.
I speak loud.